In any 2 weeks, nearly 10% of the population suffers from significant itching. Itching lasting more than 6 weeks is called chronic pruritus. Numerous skin conditions and systemic illnesses can cause chronic itch lasting more than 6 weeks, causing immune disturbances. Pruritus may be localized to one area or generalized, affecting entire skin. Itching is a normal body response to protect us from harmful external insult. However, itch is a common and distressing symptom of many etiologies. It can broadly classify into 6 categories. Dermatologic or arising from skin disorders such as psoriasis, eczema, atopic dermatitis, winter itch, and urticarial rashes. Scabies, head lice, and insect bites are also common causes of itch related to parasites. 2. Systemic or arising from internal diseases such as liver disease, cirrhosis, kidney failure, and blood cancers. Itching due to neurogenic or arising from disorders of nervous system, such as brain tumors and local nerve compression or irritation. Itch can be psychogenic, associate with stress, anxiety disorders, tactile hallucinations. Many medicines can cause pruritus. Antibiotics, pressure drugs, painkillers, and cancer drugs. Undetermined origin. During an episode of acute itch or peripheral itch like mosquito bites, the epidermis or outer skin often suffers a breach or chemical insult. Keratinocyte and local immune cells detect the damage. Mast cells undergo degranulation and release histamine. Histamine triggers local blood vessels to dilation and attract neutrophils and lymphocytes, the region to clear insult and repair the lesions. These changes in the local chemical environment detected by the itching sensory nerve ending causing a temporary itch sensation. The response usually resolves within a day or two. Let's see what is systemic or central itch. When kidney or liver failure occurs where your body has affected with critical conditions, that produces various chemicals including histamine and ammonia. These substances travel through the blood to peripheral nerves and give rise to the perception of itch where there is no actual skin disease. Contagious itch is a curious phenomenon in which viewing other scratch comes itch in the viewer. What else can cause pruritus with no rashes? Generalized pruritus without rash, especially in people over 65 years of age, is most commonly caused by dry skin, which is being repeatedly irritated. It may also be caused by medicines or by internal diseases affecting the body. There remain around 10% of individuals with itch and no apparent underlying cause or rash. This is more common in the elderly. It is always important to look for underlying causative condition, as the most effective management of pruritus without rash depends on the treatment of any underlying disease. The management of itch depends on the cause. Appropriate investigation necessary to exclude malignancy, especially in the elderly population. Itching needs to be investigated thoroughly with blood checkups and scans. Depend on clinical presentation. 10% of blood cancers initially present as itching, so keep that in mind. When pruritus is a symptom of an internal disorder, treatment of an internal disorder will sometimes lead to the resolution of itch. Stopping causative drugs that can lead to the resolution of pruritus. Let's see, what can we do to relieve itching? Elimination of provocative factors are important. Wear soft, breathable clothing, no wool clothes, no rough fabrics. Avoid excessive bathing, lukewarm baths or showers for 15 minutes with syndets. Syndets are synthetic detergents designed for sensitive skin. They are hypoallergenic cleansers. These don't contain perfumes and dyes. Syndets can use all skin types, no soap. It tallies with neutral pH of the skin. These are the best products for dry skin. Now we are moving on to one of the hot topic emollients or moisturizers. People with pruritus usually have dry skin, and therefore emollients may help to moisturize dry skin. They ease itching, reduce scaling, soften cracked areas, and help the penetration of other topical treatments. Use emollients daily. Application immediately after bathing. Soak and seal. Emollient will seal the water inside the skin and hydrate your skin. It helps the outer layer of the skin function better as a barrier to the outside world. Emollients soothe, smooth, and hydrate the skin. Reduce dryness or scaling. Its effect is short-lived, so it needs to apply frequently. You can apply according to your skin dryness. Can apply frequently, even 2 to 4 hourly, depends on your skin condition. Generally, 3 to 4 applications per day are adequate. Apply emollients on hair direction rather than applying haphazardly, which can cause inflammation of hair follicle or folliculitis. There are many different types of moisturizers, varying in their degree of greasiness, and it's important that you choose one that you like to use. Cream, water-based, non-sticky. Ointment is the best one to use. They are greasy and sticky. General tips to relieve itching. Interrupting the itch-scratch cycle. Pruritus can lead to a cycle of itching and scratching that can develop into a habit and be very hard to break. Anything you can do to take your mind off the itching will help to reduce or stop the scratching. Try to avoid situations where you tend to scratch by changing your habits. Try patting the skin instead of scratching. Avoid soaking in baths for long periods as hot water may remove the natural oils from your skin. Bathe or shower quickly in tepid water no more than once daily. Avoid using soaps or foaming body washes even if they claim to be good for dry, itchy skin. Many of these contain detergents that remove natural oil from the skin. A cooled emollient or moisturizer, which has been kept in the refrigerator, can give a more soothing effect. Keep your bedroom cool and do not sleep with heavy or heat-retaining bedclothes. If you're hot and itchy during the day, a fan can help to cool the skin down. Emollients, creams, lotions, and ointments contain oils which can catch fire. When emollient products get in contact with dressings, clothing, bed linen, or hair, there is a danger that naked flame or cigarette smoking could cause these to catch fire. To reduce the risk, you should avoid smoking cigarettes and candles. Application of protective clothes. One of the treatment options commonly used in children, especially in atopic dermatitis, where frequent itching and manipulation lead to bacterial infection and worsening of eczema in atopic children. Whole body garments are designed to depend on body build. A child can wear it at night, where itching tends to worsen. Fingertip eczema or hand eczema commonly encountered in clinical practice. Wearing garments with moisturizing effect will soothe and rapidly aid healing. Always keep nails short. Controlled physical exercise, minimize exposure to dust and heat. Reduce stress and anxiety. Anti-itch creams. Some creams containing anti-itch agents in addition to their moisturizing effect can be bought over the counter, like Rotamiton and Luromacrogols. Dopin cream, which has antihistamine action when applied in cream form. Topical steroid creams or ointments. These will usually settle the redness and itching when there is an active inflammatory skin condition. Antihistamines. An antihistamine tablet or syrup can help to improve some causes of pruritus. Sedating antihistamines. Those make you drowsy. Are no longer generally recommended in managing itch or pruritus. This includes those that can be purchased without a prescription, such as chlorpheniramine, but if you wish to have a nap, you can also try this. Some antidepressant tablets, like amitriptyline, may be prescribed by your doctor. Taken at night, can help you sleep if it is disturbed by itching. Phototherapy is another treatment option for itching. Ultraviolet light treatment given in the hospital can help reduce pruritus or the itch scratch cycle. It is commonly used in severe atopic eczema. We hope that you gained good knowledge regarding itching, its causes, and management. We hope this will help you ease the itch you have been suffering for ages. Thank you so much for watching, and make sure you subscribe to our channel. See you next time. Bye.